I wanted to make this video covering the units of concentration because right after the mole, they are the second most important units that need to be well understood for chemistry. But before we dig into it, let's establish some terms first. If you have a glass of water, up say 500 milliliters, and you add 5 grams of sugar, you'll have created a solution. The water is known as the solvent. It's the compound to which you add the sugar, which is known as the solute. The solute is generally a solid, but it can also be a liquid or a gas. So by adding a solute to the solvent, we create a solution. And since the solution involves water as the solvent, it has a special name. It's called an aqueous solution. The unit of concentration is the amount or mass of solute that's dissolved in 1 liter of solvent. You can represent it using the mass concentration, like in this case, we have 5 grams of sugar for 500 milliliters, so we can normalize that value to 1 liter, which makes us have a sugar concentration of 10 grams per liter. Of course, we can also define it with a molar concentration, by converting the mass of sugar into moles, which gives us a concentration of roughly 0.029 moles per liter. The molar concentration is sometimes denoted using square brackets like this, by putting the chemical compound, in our case sucrose, inside of the brackets. Also, chemists like to use the symbol capital M to represent the units of moles per liter. The molar concentration is also referred to as the molarity, and that's an important term that chemists often use. It's also worth noting here that I am using 1 liter of solution as the volume. The IB prefers to use cubic decimeters, but these values are equivalent, so 1 cubic decimeter is actually equal to 1 liter. So there are generally 2 ways to indicate the concentration, either using a mass basis or the molarity, which is a molar basis. Later on, you'll learn about different ways to indicate the concentration, such as the percentage, the ppm, the ppb, the ppt. All of those stand for parts per million, parts per billion, and parts per trillion, respectively. There's also the molality, which is the moles of solute divided by the mass of solvent. But those are not so important right now, but do let me know in the comments if you want me to do a quick overview of those other units. What you'll notice about the unit of concentration is that it is a derived unit. It's actually built from 2 of the 7 basic units described in the SI system. It is either the mole or the mass, divided by the length unit of the decimeter to the power of 3. Like I previously mentioned, although the cubic decimeter is the official unit of volume used by the IB, it is equivalent to the liter, which is way more commonly used in the world. So this video should have solidified your understanding of the units of concentration. You should have a clearer understanding of what a solute, a solvent, and a solution are. If the solution uses water as the solvent, it is generally referred to as an aqueous solution. The units of concentration are either by a mass basis or a molar basis. And the molar concentration is referred to as the molarity. And it has a special way of writing the symbol and denoting the concentration using square brackets. As practice, try seeing if you can find the mass in grams of sodium chloride needed to form an aqueous solution with a volume of 250 cubic centimeters and a concentration of 1.25 moles per cubic decimeter. The molar mass of sodium chloride is 58.44 grams per mole. So to solve this, I'm going to write everything in one line here. We know that we have a molarity of 1.25, which means 1.25 moles per liter. For clarity, we know that 1 liter is equal to 1 cubic decimeter. And we also know that 1 cubic decimeter is equal to 1,000 cubic centimeters. So then we can multiply by the volume, 250 cubic centimeters, to figure out how many moles we need, and then we can convert that to the mass by using the molar mass. This method of being able to write out your conversions like this is great, because it allows you to cancel out units at the top and the bottom of each fraction, and if we cancel out moles with moles, liters with liters, we cancel out the cubic decimeters and the cubic centimeters, we're only left with the grams, and that's how we know that we did this conversion properly.